Background for my video. This is actually my wardrobe. So as you have already judged by the title of this video, today's video is going to be about how I organize my messy closet. Now this is what my cupboard closet looks like, and I am generally not that disorganized, but recently I had my exams and there was a wedding and there was a lot of things happening. It's almost midnight and we are going to declutter our wardrobe, like my wardrobe. They're gonna help me, so I hope it is helpful for you all, because I know a lot of us are scared of organizing the winter closet and switching from summer to winter because it's so much hectic. But trust me, you can do it. If I can do it, you can do it too. So to start off, make sure you are in your comfiest clothes while doing the cleaning part. So I'm wearing my sweats and my PJs today, and also make sure that your hair and everything are tied up. So my next tip is, before starting, just make sure you have ample time to clean out the whole cupboard in one go. And in case you're scared of doing it all by yourself, make sure you have someone. You can ask your mother to help you out, or your maid, or your sister, or a friend, whatever is convenient to you if you're scared. So yeah, I have my sister and my friend helping me out today. So yeah, just make sure you have enough time, like you work it out. It's not like you just have an hour and you think you can clean your whole cupboard. And also you can choose whatever time is suitable to you. The free time that I get to clean my cupboard is during weekends, and that too during night time. And also set up a time limit. Like, you don't want to spend your whole day cleaning out your closet. Just take around 2 to 3 hours and just do it right away. And yeah, you can take coffee breaks, or you can just eat in between. That's totally optional to you. But next, what I like to do is I put on some music while doing all these cleaning stuff, because it really helps in calming down. Got my favorites playlist on, and I'll probably put that up while cleaning the whole cupboard. So to start off, I will show you guys a little bit of what my cupboards look like before, like a before and after thing. I'll show that to you as well. And I'm just gonna start by pulling out everything out of my closet on my bed, so that this whole thing is all cleared, and I will show all the compartments to you. And I'll just purge everything on my bed, and then I'll start with the process, and I'll take you along as I go. This is what my closet situation is currently. I've got my jeans and some scarves over here, and then I've got all of my sweaters, my pajama, my shirts, and the bag, and all the random stuff in here. The best part about cleaning your closet, you get money. And sometimes your wallet too. So before starting off by decluttering, I have used this image sort of a thing on Pinterest, which says 7 questions to ask when cleaning out your closet. So the first question, it will really help you to decide whether you want to keep a garment, or you want to throw it, or you want to donate it, whatever you want to do with that particular thing. Because many a time we tend to hold on to our clothes and we are not able to easily give it up, and that just keeps on gathering in your closet, and that is what makes your closet look messy and more clogged up. So it's the best thing that you can do while cleaning your closet or while decluttering, is to get away with most of the stuff as much as you can. So here are a couple of questions that you should ask if you have any doubt about a particular dress or a garment. First question is, does this fit? Have I worn this in the last 12 months? Is it likely I will ever wear this again? Is this currently in style, or does this still accurately represent my style, which is very important. If this is damaged in any way, will I actually make the effort to get this repaired? If I was shopping right now, would I really buy this? And do I feel confident when I wear this? So these are the 7 questions that you should ask yourself if you are confused about a particular dress or some things. So this is what I'm gonna do. I will be segregating each and every clothing item of mine into piles, and I will be keeping primarily 3 piles. One is the ones that I'm keeping, the second one is the one that I'm getting rid of them, and the third one is the ones that I'm donating, because I don't think so there's any point of keeping a cloth if you're not gonna wear it. It's better you give it to someone who can actually make use of it. Another tip for college going students is you can actually sell out your clothes online. There are a lot of websites which offer you to sell your clothes at, and people actually buy your second hand clothes at a much cheaper rate, and it also helps in providing you a little bit of pocket money, and you can actually, you know, run the cycle and invest more and more into your clothing items. Finally, my closet is now all set. I'll just give you guys a quick closet tour of how I organized everything so that it's much more clearer. So here are all of my belts and my sling bag, and then I've got all of my coats, my blazers, my denim jacket, and these are just like my shrugs, and these are all of my scarf hangers. So what I've done is I have folded all of my scarves in here, so each hanger has 3 to 4 scarves, so that it's easier for me to locate. And then these are some of my sweaters, and then I've got my coat once again. So here I've got this basket in which I've kept my beanies, my hankies, and okay, I've got a hair also, and my cute little gloves, which I really like. So then this is like my undergarments section. So I've segregated all of my undergarments as well as my spaghettis in here so that it's more easily accessible to me. And this one is a little box that I've kept for socks. So here are all of my socks, my stockings, my hand woven socks by my mom. Now this section has all of my winter wear. So these are all of my shirts and some of my tops as well. These are my inners that I wear under my sweaters and all. So these are some of my sweaters. These are also my sweaters. Back there I have all of my winter dresses, like my skirts and everything. And here are some other sweats as well. And then here I've got all of my cardigans. The last one I've got my pajamas and my pajama tops. And back there I've got two piles of my Indian wear, and those are my in summer dresses and some of other summer random tops that I'm
tank tops.
Some of my tank tops, my shorts and everything. And then here I've got all of my jeans, like these are all of my jeans which I do not wear on a daily basis, usually because they don't fit or I don't like them anymore. And these are some of my jeans which I wear on a very very regular basis, like these are my Zara jeans and then my Forever 21 jeans and my Zara jeggings of course. And here I've got my leggings, which are... So yeah, this is the whole closet. I really hope you guys like this video. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. And I'll see you guys in my next video really soon. Bye!